Hey everyone, it's modification time. I just bought these three junk guitars for $40 today in Valparaiso, Florida. And I just wanted to show you. I'm gonna transform all three of these guitars into something awesome. So I just wanted to share, and I will document the process from start to finish of each and every one of these guitars. And this one's a Behringer strap body. It's a Davidson. Yeah, it's a basic body. Alright, and this one's an Epiphone. Looks like a vintage Epiphone, actually. The paint was stripped off it, and the neck has got major damage. So you got Epiphone. This looked like it was a nice guitar at one point, but the see if I can get the light to cooperate. The neck is completely fractured. Yeah, maybe. Anyway, I'm gonna attempt to save these guitars and give them a completely new life. So we'll watch the steps of this guitar, these guitars' transformation. But I just wanted to show you. And I'm gonna save these from the landfill. Contribution to the world is to save the tree that it took to make these guitars. Maybe not this one, because that looks like a composite material, but the neck and the materials that's used. So try to give back in my own little bit of way. So I just wanted to share that with you. This is going to be fun. I'm going to completely transform each and every one of these guitars into something very cool. Thanks for following this page, and we are going to have so much fun. And the dogs say goodbye. This is Rooster.
Here.
And this is Emma. These are my children, my fur child. But anyway, so I hope everybody's having a good day. And we will talk to you soon. Alright. Hey, how's everybody doing? Alright. Just got an update on the Doctor. The Rick Nielsen's The Doctor guitar. I'm going to use this neck. And I'm going to use this body somewhere else. But I just wanted to show you the basics. As you recall, I got this guitar from a local guitar place in Valparaiso, Florida, and I'm gonna take this guitar apart and I'm gonna recycle this neck. This neck is gonna go on the Doctor guitar, and I'm gonna make it into the hammer shape guitar. Basically, it's just kind of an explorer kind of shape, and it's gonna be very cool. Anyway, just wanted to show you what it looks like before I take it apart and what I have to start with. Okay. Alright, here's everything dismantled. Neck looks pretty good. It's in good shape. I'll reshape the headstock and it's decent. Gonna have to sand it, and I'm gonna paint it white, of course, and I'm gonna make sure all the fret markers are invisible before I paint it. But anyway, there you go. Alright. Alright, another quick update on the Doctor looking guitar. Just finalizing all the different placements of where exactly the neck is going to go, where the bridge is going to line up, where the pickup is going to go. Retrace the lines to make them more sharp and precise, because when I go to paint the actual graphic on the white body guitar. But alright, next is to cut out the shape, and then go on the wood, and then cut the wood from there. I started already. It's been a long day. Got the paint done on the Billy Joe Armstrong, and I'll make another video on that. Letting that cure for a little bit. That looked really good. So, here we are. We'll see you in a bit. Alright, got it cut out. There's the shape. The Doctor. It's gonna look sweet. And I've decided to do something special with the headstock. I'm not gonna do a standard Gibson or, you know, Explorer headstock. I'm going to do a headstock reminiscent of these tips here, and I think it'll look a lot better. I think it'll look cool. Plus, it, you know, case, you know, Hammer decides to get a bug or something like that, and you made a guitar like ours, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's going to change the headshot's shape enough to where maybe they won't get mad. I don't even think you'll even see it. I'm such a small minor builder. But anyway, here's the doctor. All right, we're going to see you next up. All right, how's everybody going? Here's a quick video update of the doctor. Rick Nielsen's the doctor, electric guitars in the drawing phase. And here's what the body's going to look like with the parts. And this is going to be killer. I'm going to reshape the headstock, of course. This is a recycled neck. And I'm going to be painting this neck white. And then it's going to have the doctor on the frets. Yeah, just wanted to show you real quick, and I'm going to be doing the white version. There are a couple version pictures out there. Actually, the original, like here, Mr. Rick Nielsen himself, with his original doctor, the white. Over time, the guitar actually yellowed, like in this picture here. So, it's just that the paint, you know, over time, it tends to yellow. And, you know, I want to do the original version where it's in its white full glory. But yeah, here's the doctor. And that's what the fretboard's going to look like. I'm going to paint it on there. I'm going to paint the whole neck white, of course. And I don't think I'll do the hammer. I think I'll do my logo, the Ragland guitar in white. But, yeah, I just wanted to give you a quick video update of the good old Doctor guitar. And here's a miniature they made. So, yeah, there we go. It's going to be another colossal epic build. I can't wait to get started, cut the wood out and everything. That's next. Cutting it out and get started. All right, we'll see you soon. All right, get ready to cut out the Doctor from the wood. Here we go, the process is going to begin. Alright. Hey, how's everybody doing? Alright, I got the shape cut out. Whew.
I tell you, that was some work. But I got the doctor. The doctor guitar is
in the wood blank phase. Yeah, check it out. Pretty cool. Maybe get this sucker going. It looks cool. Anyway, just wanted to show you. Alright. Alright, just another update for you. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a rounded edge on the body on the front and the back before I cut out the neck pocket there. And the way I do that is I've got a Dremel bit that I use here, and it's kind of like a, you know, a router, and I just put like an edge on the side there. And I'll work my way around, and I'll give you another update when I get that done. But right now, see how it's all sharp? And I won't do this corner, but you see how it's sharp there? And then I put the edge on there. Okay, we'll see you in a minute. Alright, put a round edge on everything. This is the back of the guitar. Nice. Nice and smooth. And also on the front. Sand this more, of course, and I'm getting ready to add in the neck pocket. Alright, we'll see in a bit. Alright, quick update on the Doctor guitar. I'll reveal the headstock shape. That's what I'm going with. It's gonna be sweet, and it matches the back there. But yeah, I got the neck set in there, and good progress today. Oh man, whew. Cutting that little piece out was it's pretty tricky. Alright, we'll see you in a bit. Hey, how's everybody doing? Just want to share progress today. What I got done for the Doctor guitar.
Got quite a bit done. Got the body shape, cut in the neck, shaped the headstock,
and it's pretty cool. Yeah, this is going to be another epic build. You know, the two-layer, I do the two-layer design. And the bottom layer, and with the top layer too, the neck pocket I cut in, get the extra piece there. That way I can fit the neck and configure when I go to, install the bridge and everything like that. And it's going to be a regular strat-style bridge minus the tremolo. So it'll be pretty cool. But yeah, there's the progress of today's work. I think I'm going to call it for today. I'm pretty tired. Got a bunch done. But anyway, there you go. Stay tuned for all the exciting
future updates of this build. Alright, we'll see you in a little bit.
Hey, just a quick update on the doctor. I'm setting the neck. And this is how I do it in general with these top load non-trim strat style bridges. See, I set the distance, from the 13th, you check the scale length and then you mark it off. And you can see how I marked it off there. And then I've got string to make sure that the neck angle is correct, which is perfect. This neck is perfect. So I'll set it in to where it is right there. And just wanted to show you how I do it. It's a little complicated, but this method I use right here works out pretty well. And see, then I can screw in and fix the bridge now prior to painting, because then when the painting and, it's just better that way. But anyway, just wanted to show you that real quick. Alright. Hey everybody. I just wanted to show you how I seat the neck. Put the body filler in there and make the neck pocket connecting perfectly. Let's see if I can get in the light here. Yeah. And once that dries, I'll sand it smooth and make it perfect. Yeah, it's turning out pretty cool. Yeah. Alright. Alright, everything's lined up. I used the strings and I installed the bridge. Now I'm gonna put for the pickup, and I think I'm gonna like to go with an EMG active pickup in this guitar so it'll sound bad to the bone. But anyway, alright, draw it out where I'm gonna put the pickup, the single EMG 81. I drew it out. And tomorrow I'll get the saw and I'll cut this out. And then we'll go from there. Alright, good to go. Alright, how's everybody doing? Good morning. Time to get to work on the doctor guitar. The weather is cleared up.
Better. It was yesterday, so. Alright, plan today is get all the way up to the wood filler. So what I'm going to do, drill a hole for the ground, cut open the hole for the pickup, completely channeled all the electronics inside, cut open a hole for the input jack, or on the back, open up a hole for the pedometer cavity, then open a spot for the 9-volt battery. I'm gonna go with the shallow square 9-volt battery holder. And then once I get all that done, everything looks good, then I'm gonna sand all the body filler and then add all the extra body filler that I might need on the top and on the back. And then we're gonna glue both pieces together. Then I'm going to fill in all the cracks along the side and then hopefully get to the wood grain filler and coat one side with about 4 or 5 coats of wood filler, and that'll be the whole day. That'll probably take me about a good 8 hours. So hopefully get all that done today. We'll see how far it gets. Okay, we'll talk to you soon about it. Alright, got the holes drilled. I've got the ground for the bridge and an opening for the pickup channel. Now I'm getting ready to scroll saw the opening for the pickup. Alright. Alright, pickup hole has been cut. Looking good. Alright, drill the hole for the volume knob all the way through to the back, and we're going to open that up and then
route it out the guitar.
Alright, going to cut out for the 9-volt battery compartment, and then open up an access panel for the pedometer and the back of the guitar. Alright, I got the 9-volt battery access compartment cut. Now what I'll do is I'll draw where that opening is.
so I can make the well deeper, and then I can make it nowhere to route the other stuff. Set a wire channel. Okay, because you see this doesn't fit flush, so I'll have to go down and cut away and Dremel down and make it flush at the bottom. But now I've got access to, I pull this away, this is where the routing of the guitar is going to take place. So I've already did for the pedometer, and then the input jack here, and then I'll just make a dog leg over here to the 9-volt battery compartment, and that's where the channel for everything is going to go. It's pretty simple on this guitar, just one volume. So we've got the bridge, ground, and the wire going connect up to here to your pedometer, to your input jack, and to your 9-volt battery. And that's it. Alright, we're going to wrap this out and we'll see you in a little bit. Alright, another quick update. I got the 9-volt battery. This is the back of the guitar. Input jack, access panel, which it'll get this belt, which I don't think I'm going to countersink. I think I'm just going to go flush and go the other way with it, but that's going to go there, and that, and there, and let me show you the ultimate final route of the guitar itself, which is pretty simplistic on this one, which is always a good thing. There you go, there's the complete route. Okay, the
a little bit lower for the channel for the pickup into the pedometer.
And I'm going to use 500K pedometer. And that's going to go down there like that. And then the input jack, but I'll get that all set up. One second. Alright, another quick update. Just wanted to show you the final route before I glue the two pieces together. Next step is I'm gonna glue the top piece to the bottom piece, but I just wanted to show you all the intricacies of the routing. Routed, and then for plenty of room for the wire, for the, and let me show you what the final route looks like. All right, so from the bridge, let me see where I can see here. A little blinded by the light. Okay, so for the pickup, you go to the ground there, and then you route all the way to the one volume knob, and then from volume knob to the 9-volt battery cover, and then to the input jack. So it's pretty straightforward. And on the back plate, you can see I rounded out a little bit to accommodate for the input jack. And then I always do these comfort extra little nibs, just so the wires slide smoothly. So, alright, so next phase is what I call the glue phase, is where I glue both these sections together, and it becomes one solid piece. And then we'll go to the next step. See you in a minute. Update, successful glue phase. Both pieces are perfectly glued to each other, and this is awesome. And I'm going to fill all the rest of this in with body filler,
any gaps or anything like that,
and then we're going to go with the wood filler. But yeah, it turned out pretty cool. So the doctor is taking shape. Pretty soon the doctor's going to be in the house making calls. Alright, we'll see you soon. Next step. Hey, how's everybody doing? Alright, another update on the doctor guitar. All the body work, the body filler, everything's joined, all the cavities are cut out. We are to the wood fill, the wood grain fill stage, and the wood filler. So, yeah, we're going to go and get ready to enter into the ugly stage. But yeah, it is looking awesome. I mean, this thing is just killer. It's a huge body. Can't wait to do the graphic. Can't wait to paint it and do the graphic. This guitar is gonna be sweet. Yeah. I've gotta say, it's looking awesome.
I mean, who would have thought such an odd-shaped guitar would be so fun and so cool?
Yeah, here's the back. This is what it looks prior to the wood filler, prior to the ugly stage. Just the wood stage. Yeah, the neck pocket turned out really well. Everything is good to go. Like I said, it's just gonna go the wood grain. Wood filler. Ugly phase is next. So, ready for it to start looking icky until I, icky. Can't believe I said icky.
Until I sand everything smooth. But here we go. I'll see you after I put a few, halfway, when I put some wood filler on there. And we'll see you soon. All right.
I just wanted to show you how I mix up the wood filler. Yeah. And I kind of base it by feel and thickness.
I'll get this all stirred up and then I'll be right back.
All right. That's about the consistency I'm looking for this time.
Make it just a little bit hair thinner. So when I layer the coats, that it lays down a little bit more even. On the last guitar, I made it a little thicker and it laid it a little bit more pumpy. And then when I go to sand, you sand more off than you actually want to. Because you have to make it level. But that's about the consistency I'm looking for right there. And then I get the fan brush like I've showed in a past video. And dip a little bit in. Go to the spot that I want to go to. And you just put a layer. Simple as that. And you just keep putting layers. And then, this layer I'll go from left to right. The next layer I'll go up and down. So it kind of fills in all the pores and fills in everything really well. Alright, we'll see you in a little bit. Alright, here we go. Got the first coat of wood filler on there, applied. It's kind of a preview of how this beast, awesome looking guitar is going to look. Yeah, so I'll let this cure for maybe about 2 or 3 hours, and then I'll come right back and put another coat. I think I'm probably going to put about, somewhere like 7 coats on the top, just like this. And then on the back, because it's more of a wood grain, there, I put probably 9 to 10 coats. And then once it all dries, then I'll sand it and we'll take it from there. But yeah, there's the first coat. And it is looking cool. I do the sides and the top, and then of course not the bottom. I'll do the bottom afterward. But there we go. We'll see you in a little bit.
Good morning, everybody. How's everybody doing? All right, the wood filler stage has been completed. I probably put about a good,
15 layers of wood filler. Yeah, thin layers, of course. But I just wanted to show you how it looks.
It is looking awesome. I gotta admit, I mean, this shape is really growing on me. When I first started this project and I first started making this guitar, I thought the shape was a little unusual, but it was an iconic guitar and I wanted to recreate it. But it's really growing on me. Let me show you the back here. This is amazing. Of course, it's the ugly face, so I'm going to sand all this really smooth. I can't wait to show you that. But let me show you the back. Yeah. I can't wait to start putting some primer and some paint on this and then working on the graphic.
It is going to be so amazing. Plus, I've got EMG going in there, so, this guitar is going to sound amazing. And it's fun to show you. Pretty good progress.
Weather is definitely a lot better, so
today I'll be sanding this
nice and smooth and possibly putting some primer next time.
I'll put some primer coats on there and then white, of course, gloss white. But yeah, it is looking awesome.
I do like this guitar a lot. this is why, you know, making guitars is so awesome. I mean, you get to
do stuff like this, and
it's just so gratifying when you see something that comes from a drawing that, you know, you get off, you know, and you drawing that of a guitar that you saw on the internet, and you recreate it and make it, you bring it to life and you make it an actual thing. Because I can imagine there's only one of these, the real guitar, the Rick Nielsen, the Doctor guitar. He probably only had one made, and it's probably somewhere in his vault of, you know, several thousand guitars somewhere in the corner that hasn't been looked at in probably years.
But it's just awesome. And I'm glad I can share this with you. I mean, it
feels really good to be able to do this and bring you along on the journey. Okay, we'll see you on the next step, sanding. And I hope everybody has a good day, and we'll see you soon. All right, good morning, everybody. I'm doing the fretwork on the Rick Nielsen, the Doctor guitar. I'll get all this done, and then I'll sand the neck here. And I'm going to paint the neck fully white, except for the front. It's going to be black, and with my logo right there. I'm going to sand all that and make it all perfect. But yeah, I'm going to paint the whole neck gloss white. And then I'm going to paint on the Doctor graphic in black and red. So that should be very interesting, very cool. See how it turns out. All right, see you in the next step. All right, next step is completed. I've got all the frets leveled, crowned, and polished. And they are glowing. Take a look. Yeah, okay, time to strip off all this tape and get it prepped for primer coats, and we'll see you after the next step. Alright, tape's off. I just wanted to show you the shine of the frets. Are leveled, ground, and polished. Of course, I'm going to sand this whole neck now and prep it for primer. I'm going to be painting this entire neck white, of course, with the exception of the headstock, the front. From this point on, it's going to be black with the white logo. And then on the frets, I'm going to put the Doctor facing this way, of course. The Doctor. So I just wanted to show it to you and appreciate and got everything. And when I put the primer coat on here, I'll see if I'll need to fill in anything like that, but I'm gonna get it perfect as possible. But here are the frets now, nice and shiny. That's always what you go for. Okay, see you in the next step. Hey, how's everybody going? All right, I got all the individual frets taped off, and we are ready for some primer coat. Plus, I got the neck mounted to my custom hanger I just made for this particular thing. And I'm going to put some primer. I was considering going primer and paint. I still might do that because these individual frets, want to try to make it as clean as possible. It's pretty good sandpaper, or pretty good tape that I used. But we'll see. Wish me luck. I'm going to put a coat on there and see what it does, and then I'll be back to you. Okay. Hey everyone, just another quick update on the Doctor guitar. Got the neck painted white, still got to clean it up a little bit. There's a little bit of paint on the frets, but I'll scrape that off. It turned out okay. Not as good as I had hoped, but it'll work. I mean, the paint, you know, and it's kind of humid and, you know, a little bit of dust in the garage. But other than that, I mean, it's acceptable. I'm not dissatisfied with it, but yeah, it's the shape is really killer. But I'll get to work once this cures for a day or two, and I'll get to work on the Doctor on the frets, and then paint the front of the headstock black, and then put the logo, and then start working on the body again. But yeah, you can see where there's, you know, this, it's not 100% perfect. I could sand it when it dries completely. Thinking maybe I go a 2K over everything once I get, you know, everything, you know, like the inlay and everything like that, but it might not be necessary. I'll have to kind of play it by ear, but just a quick update.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. Pretty decent. It took a while. 2K. Alright, we'll see you in a little bit.
Morning, everybody. Beautiful day here in Florida. The sun is shining. We are good to go. Okay. Time to sand the sucker and to make it smooth and beautiful. All right. Wish me luck. This is the stuff that I'll be using. Here's my dogs. That's Emma. That's Brewster. They love when I make guitars. Anyway. I just wanted to show you how it looks before the sanding starts. I showed you in the last video. Yeah. And we're going to make this beautiful. We're going to make it nice and smooth. And I think the weather is permitting that we're going to put some primer on this thing today. So I'm going to install the hanger, hang it from here, and we're going to put some primer on there. All right, see you in a little bit. Hey everyone, taking a break, want to share an update. Yeah, it's coming along. This is a long process, so it's taking a while. I still got the side tiers here, as you can see, but I want to show you how smooth in the progress of the actual sanding part, how smooth it comes. And I'm out of the light figures, but yeah, you see how I got these tiers, see how rough it is, but then you see how smooth let's see if I can get the light to cooperate here on this side. Yeah, you can see the difference. Anyway, getting there, taking a break. Whew. This, like I said, this process does take a while, but it's so worth it. Look at that, look at how awesome that is. Yeah, see how smooth? And once I get it smooth, then I'll put a layer of glitter primer on there to seal all this in. All right, we'll see you in a bit. Hey, got another update on the Dr. guitar. All the sanding has been completed. Just wanted to show you what it looks like before the primer coats. Looks good. It took a long time to get here, but it is smooth and looking sweet. I'll put the hanger on. I'll do another short clip before the primer coats go on. Also in the back, I'm gonna have to put some extra filler in. There's a couple lines that developed here for sanding. Let me show you the back. It looks like a squid, doesn't it? The doctor. Yeah, see these little lines that developed. It happens with this wood. I'm gonna fill that in with some putty real quick before I put the primer coats. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's that many. And then after the primer, you let that dry for a day, and then you see if you find any other perfections, and you sand the primer, and then you just put another layer of primer before the base coat of white goes on. But yeah, let me do that real quick. I'll fill these with the paste. Actually, what I use for that is, what I do with it? Oh, here it is right here. I use this right here, Bondo glazing putty. And it fills in fine lines like that. And I'll fill those in and then sand them and put on the hanger, and we're ready to put some primer.
Looks awesome. Alright, see you in a bit.
Alright, we're on the hanger and we are good to go for primer coats. Whew. Took a lot to get to this point, but here she is. I'm gonna spray a few coats of primer on there and see how she does. We'll see you in a little bit. Fingers crossed. update. Primer coats have been completed and it's looking awesome.
It's a sandable primer too, so in between coats I was sanding and trying to smooth everything, making it more perfect.
Yeah, it's looking pretty good. So
this is after probably 7-8 coats of primer.
But it's looking good. And it's outside in the light. It's kind of hard because it's kind of shady. But I'm going to take it indoors. And then I'll let it hang for a day or two. And then sand it. And then we'll go with the white coat. And then that'll have to cure for about a week.
And then
start doing the graphics. And it's going to be awesome.
But alright, we'll see you inside.
Alright, inside. Primer coats are done, like I said earlier.
Man, you really don't notice how big this thing really is until it's one solid color. When it's wood, it's actually deceiving. It doesn't look as big. I mean, it really doesn't weigh that much per se. I mean, I don't know the exact weight. I'll get the exact weight when I get done. But it's I mean, if you look at it compared to the Psycho guitar line, this thing like dwarfs them. Even the skull and crossbones, it's kind of dwarfed. And the other guitars here, this thing is like huge. But as the proportions of what it was, so it's amazing. But I just wanted to show you. I doubt I can turn this around. Well, I might be able to turn it around. Yeah, see, it's really not that heavy, per se. Hold on, let me turn it around, stick it on the hanger here. Don't want it to fall off or anything. That would suck. But yeah, here's the backside. Yeah, it looks good, though. The primer really good, and all that sanding. Like I said, I was sanding in between layers of primer. Here, let me turn it back around. So, I mean, I'm a fairly strong guy, but, you know, one arm strength. If I were to have to guess the poundage, over 10 for sure, but less than 15, so I can imagine. But this thing, you figure, it's, with the neck attached, it's probably going to be upwards of 2.5-3 feet big. So, but you know, Rick Nielsen's known for his, you know, quad neck guitar and everything like that. I mean, even his Uncle Dick guitar is fairly large. I mean, when he stands next to it. But anyway, just want to give you a quick update. So let this cure for a day or so. And a little bit of sanding, and then we'll go with the white paint. And I can't wait to get to the graphic and put the graphic on there. It's going to be sweet. And, alright, well, see you soon. Alright, how's everybody doing? A little bit of update on the Doctor guitar. I've got the primer that's set for a day or so. It should be nice and dry. I'm going to sand it a little bit and make it smooth, blow it off. And then we're going to go with some clear coat or some white gloss. This is the paint I'm going to do. I got some of the Rust-Oleum and I got some of this, but this just says it's like super adhesive, 5 times the stronger adhesion. So I'm gonna give this a whirl and see how it goes. Fingers crossed. Probably put about 8, 9, 10, 11, whatever coats on here. Make it real pretty, and we'll see you in a little bit. I'll document the progress of it. All right, we'll see you in a little bit.
All right, good morning, everybody. Sanding is, the primer has been completed, and we are ready for some base coats.
Just wanted to show you how smooth it turned out prior to the white coats going on. If you could feel that, it's just smooth. I sanded it with 800 grit sandpaper, and all these little cracks and crevices, I'll have to brush in the base coat later on, which is fine. And then once I put the clear coat, you know, it'll all blend in. But I just wanted to show you real quick what it looked like before the base coats get applied. And you can see how smooth. Oh yeah, it turned out really well. I can't wait. Alrighty. And there she is.
the doctor prior to some white base coat paints. And I'm gonna go with the Krylon. I might have said that in an earlier update, but I'm gonna go with the Krylon Fusion all-in-one paint right here in gloss white. And we're gonna be good to go. All right, fingers crossed everything goes well and a bug or a hair or spider web or something doesn't get in the finish. But anyway, we'll see you in a bit. All right, it's time to work on the doctor inlay. And I sketched out what it looks like. And I'm going to cut it out with an X-Acto blade, and then we're going to apply it to the neck. See you in a sec. All right, time to put the doctor on the fretboard. Fingers crossed it turns out the way I hope it will. And here we go. I'll check back with you in a sec. Another quick update on the doctor guitar. I got the black doctor inlay put together on the guitar, which is looking sweet. Now I gotta do the red accents. And of course I'm gonna color the top part, the front facing of the headstock black, and then with the white logo. But doctor is on the frets, so it looks pretty cool. The doctor. Alright, we'll see you next step. Alright, another update real quick. Just finished the doctor inlay, and it is looking sweet. I'm so happy, so pleased the way it turned out. That is definitely cool. And it's just like the original, very close. Of course, you know, I put my little stank on it here and there. This is a 22 fret neck as opposed to 24 fret, which is on the original, so I had to adjust and move over. Normally the R to the right started on the 5th fret, but because of the spacing, I spaced it over and, you know, made it work so it's centered in the center of the neck. But yeah, there's the doctor. And we're gonna let this dry, and then, you know, any touch-ups you need to do. So it turned out pretty cool. Alright, can't wait to get the paint on the body. Talk to you in a little bit. Alright, update, all the base coats have been completed, and I just finished. And it is looking amazing. I am so pleased with the results. Oh, look at that. That is just so awesome. Oh my god, look at that. All that extra effort and making it smooth really turned out. I mean, it just looks incredible. It looks like something actually that, you know, you would find from a professional, you know, like something done from, like, you know, instead of being a handmade instrument to being a professionally. Wow, look at the I'll do another video inside once I get it hung up, but I mean, it's just awesome. Okay, one note though, one little gripe. I started off using Krylon, and the nozzle was, you know, two separate cans. The Krylon, this stuff right here. I started off using this, so I was gonna try, like I was saying before, and the nozzle was clogging, it was blotching out, it was spitting out little goobers everywhere. Man, I got one coat on there and I had to go through there and re-touch up everything, and thank God. Here's the only scar from the Krylon, you can barely see it, but there was like a big old run that developed from belly spraying that thing. So I learned, you know, the Krylon in this particular scenario wasn't good. But luckily I bought both, and the Rust-Oleum came through and saved the day. So, just wanted to show you. And of course, I'll let this dry for a full week or so, and then I'll start to apply the graphic on the front.
And the doctor will come into view.
So awesome. So I just wanted to show you that. Yeah, it's looking good.
Look at that. I mean, I guess it's true. I mean, practice makes perfect. I mean, the more you do it, the better you get at it. Painting used to be my Achilles heel. I always hated painting. I was not any good at it. The finish always looked bad. It was always bumpy and wrinkly, and it looked just sloppy. And yeah, it's getting better. I mean, this isn't perfect by no means, but it's definitely improved. So, all right, we'll see you in a little bit. Hey everyone, just another quick update on the doctor headstock. I got the headstock the way I want it, and of course I'll put some clear coats on there, and it'll make it uniform and shiny and perfect. I am going to do the 2K, but I got a little surprise. On the back, I decided to put this.
A Rick Nielsen tribute guitar. With a good old Orton Nielsen himself.
So I thought that was a cool touch. So yeah, that'll be really killer. And when I put the 2K, it'll be super glossy and everything will be matching and uniform. But I just wanted to show you the update today. Pretty cool.
Yeah, it went with my logo. Seeing how I changed the headstock up a bit for the original.
And still waiting on the body to cure. It's dying for some graphics. And the graphics will be coming soon. So, just kind of a preview. The doctor. Yeah. This is a cool thing. Yeah, good old Ricky. Alright, we'll see y'all in a little bit.
All right, how's everybody doing? Great day today. Chilly day here in Florida. Yeah, I got good news. Today's the day we start on the graphic for the doctor guitar. And here's the initial layout cutout. And what I'm going to do, got an X-Acto blade here with a sharp, brand new, fresh blade. These are the blades I use. And I'm going to cut out the shape. And then I'm going to place it on the body of the guitar, and I'm going to draw it out with my fine tip marker and then start painting it in. It's going to be a long process. It's going to be very cool. I got to be very gentle and very diligent about it, and I want to try to make it as perfect as possible. But we will see you shortly, and I'll show you the process of me actually cutting this out. All right, we'll see you in a minute. All right, here are the first cutouts I'm going to transfer over. I can't cut it all out, of course, because the shapes would be independent of each other. So I'm just going to transfer these over to the body. Wish me luck, fingers crossed. All right, here's the first transfer. Whew, that's a bit stressful. You only get one shot at this. All right, we'll see you in a bit. All right, here's the second cutout. I'm getting ready to transfer it over on the guitar. Whew. All right, the inlay has been completed. Whew, transfer over. It was a little bit hair biting, or nail biting rather. Yeah. Now the fun part of painting all the lines in the colors that they need to be. Whew. Alright, we'll see you in the next step. Leftover scrap bits from the transfer. Where's the nose? I think. Yeah, and the nose. Yep. Yeah, the doctor's nose. All right, another quick update on the doctor. Working on the graphic.
Whew, taking my first break. Whew, that's intense.
Yeah, but it's looking pretty good so far. It's got one little touch up in the top there, but do the white touch up, but yeah. And then I'll put 2K clear coat over this. Of course, you know that. But yeah, it looks pretty sweet. Alright. We'll see you in a little bit. Alright. It's getting there. The doctor. Sweet. Alright. It's awesome. Whew. It's getting there. Alright, it's getting there. Just a little bit left to go. Oh man, it's been a few hours doing this. Looking good though, that is sweet. The doctor. Alright, see you in a minute. Yay, how's everybody doing? Quick update on the doctor guitar. The graphics have been completed. Oh yes, on the top. That is... It's taken almost all day, but it looks awesome. I'm so happy. All right. So now I'm gonna let this dry for a day or so and then apply 2K clear coat over it to seal everything in and make everything glossy. And then let that set for a few days and then time to put the doctor together. Oh, that is just awesome. Alright. Everybody have a great night, and we'll see you in a little bit. The doctor says, hey. Real quick, I just wanted to show you a preview of the neck with the body. Oh man, the doctor. Sweet. Alright. See you in a little bit. Alright, another update on the doctor guitar. I am taping up the frets and we are preparing for 2K clear coat. Yeah. Once I get all these frets taped up, I'm going to put the 2K over the whole neck, including the headstock and around it, everything, and it's going to look sweet. And then that's going to have to dry for a day or two. And then I'm still waiting on the 2K can for the body, and I'm letting that paint dry really, really well. But yeah, okay, I'll see you in a few minutes after I get these frets taped up. All right, got the frets all taped up, and we are ready for a clear coat. Some 2K clear coat's gonna make this neck just look shiny and brilliant. Alright, we'll see you in a bit. Hey, how's everybody doing? Getting good evening. The Dr. Guitar has got 2K clear coat and it's already been drying for about a day and a half, 2 days or so. So tomorrow morning I am all set to assemble this guitar and make it come into life. So the end is near. Let me see if I can show you how shiny and beautiful this is with the 2K clear coat. Yeah, that's awesome. And it's sealed in the graphic and everything like that. So, and it's cool. And let me show you the neck real quick. The neck's got the 2K clear coat as well. Let's see if I can do this. How am I going to do this one hand? Yeah. Hold on 1 second. Alrighty. And the neck turned out awesome. And see how the headstock with the 2K clear coat made everything perfect. Well, not perfect, but it made it just uniform and just awesome. So, yeah, this is pretty sweet. All right, just a quick update on the Dr. Electric Guitar. Like I said earlier, I'm going to start the build tomorrow. I'm going to start to assemble it, and I'll definitely share all the updates with that. But yeah, it's going to be awesome. Tomorrow is going to be the day when the doctor comes to life. So, alright, we'll see you soon. Can't wait for tomorrow. It's going to be awesome. It's been a long journey with this guitar, but the conclusion is near, so we will see you soon.
Thanks again.
Good morning, everybody. This fine, chilly day, February 4th, 2022. We are ready to assemble the Dr. Guitar. And these are all the parts I'll be putting on there and all the equipment I'll be using. It is time. It's been a long time coming, but we're going to put this baby together right now. So, fingers crossed. Wish me luck. Everything goes smoothly. I don't have any mishaps. Anything happens that catastrophic failures or anything. So, all right. And now, first step is going to be to put a wire for the grounding wire and then install the bridge, the pickups, then install the wiring. So that's going to be the first steps. So we'll see you at the next step. All right, wish me luck. All right, got the wire for the ground for the bridge, and now it's time to install the bridge over it. All right, the bridge is installed. That's always a stressful part. Any of these five screws could snap while you're installing them, and then you would have a complete bad problem. But luckily, I was able to get them in there and tight without any events. So, all right, we'll see you at the next step. Gonna install the pickup. Bridge and the pickup placed now, and then I got the wires stretched all the way down. Now I'm gonna turn it over and start wiring process. All right, get ready to install the input jack. I got it all wired up and everything, and install the screws, and we'll catch back up to you. All right, I put in the battery compartment and I wired it through. This is the battery, this is the input jack, and or this is the pickup and the ground, and these are the input jack. So I'm going to screw this in and then get to wiring and then get the pedometer ready and all that. All right, we'll see you in a bit. All right, got the battery compartment screwed in and getting ready to wire everything together. All right, got everything wired and tested. Everything is good to go. Gonna put the pedometer in and the knob, and then put the cover on the back, and we should be good to go. It's just, this is a very stressful part, so it's hard to film and do it. Just want to make sure I don't mess anything up. Alright, we'll see you in a minute. Alright, everything's good to go. So I'm going to put the cover on it, and it's looking good so far. So, fingers crossed, everything else goes smooth. Alright. Alright, back plate cover is installed. Everything is good to go on the body. I'm going to hang this back up and work on the neck. I'll flip it over and I'll show you the button, or the knob. Alright, everything on the body has been completed. Whew, that's some stressful stuff right there. Now the fun part comes. Now we're going to install the neck. It's pretty cool. The doctor is getting there. Alrighty. See you when I get the neck out and start working on the neck. Ooh, wish me luck. Fingers crossed, everything goes smooth. Hey, real quick, I just want to double check it and test it again. Get everything buttoned up, but sometimes things can move, you know, when you're putting in the knob and everything like that. So, let's see. Let's take a... Yeah. So I got it plugged in. Input jack. I got the volume turned on 10. And there you go. And then you turn the volume down. And if there's nothing, then we're good to go. Everything worked out. All right, we'll see you in the neck. All righty, ready to work on the neck for the doctor. Gonna install the tuners, take it off the hanger, install the string tree, and then get ready to put it, or I gotta install the nut also. Yeah, I forgot about that, the nut. I left it out because when I was painting it, I didn't want to get the paint all over the nut. I know that sounds kind of paint on your nuts. It's not good to have paint on your nuts. But anyway, I'll see you in a minute. Alright, it's time to install the nut. I did sand it down just a little bit so it fits nice and good. And put a couple drops of CA glue just to seal it in. It's nice and snug in there, but not too snug. So I'll see you when I get that done. Okay. Alright, got the nut installed. I said I put about 3 tiny drops of CA glue in there, and we are good to go. See the next step. Gonna put the tuners in and the string tree. Alright, got the string tree installed, and now time to put in the tuners. It's a good thing about you when you use recycled necks like that, all the holes and everything's already drilled, so you don't have to worry about breaking off any screws in there. Alright, we'll see you in a bit. Alright, we're getting there. Alright, Alrighty, I got all the hardware installed and we are good to go. Time to join the neck to the body. Yeah. Like I said, I like using recycled necks because, like I said, all the holes are already pre-drilled, so there's no question. Alright. Here's the stressful part. Hopefully this goes well. Alright, we'll see you in a sec. Alright, it is that time. It is time to join the neck to the body for the first time since it's been reborn here, since it's been birthed. This is a very stressful part, so fingers crossed that it all joins well and everything goes good. Alright, here we go. We'll see you when I get there. Alrighty. The neck's attached. Whew. I tell you what, that's a stressful. That's the most stressful part to attach the neck, especially when you put so much paint on there. You hope for no chip away or anything like that. I mean, anything could have happened, but it turned out awesome. Here, let me show you the back. It is sweet. Look at them there. I'll do a full video, of course, of. You know, full everything, but yeah, there you go. All right, we're gonna string this sucker up and then hopefully all my measurements and everything, all the calculations and all the work and all the planning, it all paid off here. And then we'll have the Doctor tribute guitar. This sucker's big, it's long. Yeah, look it compared to, you know. All right, we'll see you in a little bit. Alrighty, I got her all stringed up and everything's looking good so far. Got the neck attached and everything's good to go. Gonna do a full setup, but this is the Doctor put together here. It's looking amazing. So, alright, I'm gonna do a full setup and everything like that and then do a full picture shoot. And I'll do some more videos of this when I get it more dialed in, but yeah, it's looking awesome. I mean, that is just, that's crazy. It's the Doctor. Yeah. I hope Rick Nielsen sees this video and sees this amazing guitar that he inspired. So, alright, we'll see you in a little bit. Hey, how's everybody doing? Yeah, I just wanted to show another update. Got it all complete, got it all set up, playing good, sounding good, intonated. The action's incredible. The EMG pickup sounds amazing. It's just, I've got a... I mean, the strings are going to stretch a little bit, brand new strings, but it's pretty much in tune. See, the action is really low. It's perfect. It plays amazing. I'm so surprised. It's a huge guitar. But yeah, I'll do a full photo shoot and I'll do a playing demo. Some cheap trick preferably. But yeah, the Doctor, that's pretty sweet. Just a quick update. I'll post all the updated videos too, and then this will be a part of the series where it's completely, you know, from the start of the build to the completed build, and this will be a part of that series too. So, just wanted to show you again the Doctor. Yeah, very rare guitar, one of a kind. Now there's one, you know, copy of it. It's not exactly like it, of course. That stock's different. It's not the hammer shape, explorer shape, but I wanted to do a little something, you know, I wanted to recycle the neck I had on hand, but yeah, it's pretty awesome. But anyway, alright, we will see you soon. The Doctor is here.
If anybody can, please share this video. That'd be so awesome if Rick can see this amazing guitar that he inspired by his awesome guitar collections. The Doctor. Alright, we'll talk to you later. Alright, this is the part of the video where I tried to make a bunch of sound clips just to see how the guitar sound and played, and made a bunch of different clips, me being a novice filmmaker or vlogger. I just thought I'd show you them all, so here they are.
Hey, how's everybody doing? Alright, this is the Doctor guitar. Rick Nielsen tribute guitar of the Doctor. And as I promised, I just wanted to give you a sound check on just the way it sounds, how it sounds. Just a brief little sound clip demo of what this guitar sounds like and how it plays. I got the distortion, so it's, you know, it's got the EMG pickup, so it sounds... song here, see if we can get some sound comparisons. Give you a quick little sound. Thank you. How's everybody doing? Alright, I just wanted to give a sound update. Sound check on the Doctor guitar. As you know, this is a guitar I'd been building for quite a while, and it is complete, and I thought I'd do a sound check for you. How are you doing? Alright, the Doctor guitar. As you have been following me, know that I just finished this guitar not too long ago. And as I promised, I wanted to give you a sound check on how it sounds and how it plays. And let me just give you some brief sounds. How's everybody doing? Alright, the Doctor guitar is in the house. As I promised, I wanted to give you a sound check of how this guitar sounds and how it plays. And let me just give you a brief little rundown. The Doctor guitar, pretty sweet. Yeah, give you some chords. That's not a half. Half volume, this is a full volume with the distortion. It's got EMG pickup in it, so it's... Thank you.